This is Lean Discovery sitting with the C-suite. I'm Clinton Sanko with Baker Donaldson, and today my guest is Joan Davison of Higher Counsel and Mestel & Company. When you look at the legal industry in general, the legal process outsourcing that has happened over the last over a decade has really changed the view of law firms and clients as to what is possible with staffing. And I've heard you use the term several times, a human capital strategy, as a kind of a key term. But what do you see in terms of what's possible with a human capital strategy looking forward for corporate clients and law firms? What opportunities are out there to leverage human capital strategies to their greatest extent on a go-forward basis?
Yeah, that's a great question. Outsourcing's been around for a long time. I think as the legal community continues to embrace it, I happen to be with an insurance executive in the last probably 6 months or so, who literally walked out of a boardroom and said, gosh, one of our challenges is that the board now wants legal to be more of a profit center. You know, we've been spending all this money and they're really coming back and pushing us very hard, and I've got to kind of get ahead of it. And I'm curious, help me kind of, what do you think, right? Kind of high level. And when you look at that and you look at those opportunities for where GCs can really benefit, we all know that taking process that is more standardized or more rope can certainly be outsourced with a degree of consistency and done very effectively. So from a GC perspective, take an example of contracts management, right? You can really look at that area and work with an outsourcing organization to really become more proficient at it. Now, some people would say, well, okay, that's one avenue. We're going to get a small ROI in that proficiency. And okay, that's great. But when you really look at that, what from my perspective, right, from our perspective that we see as a company, really those effective general counsels look at that process, take the ROI, but it's the next question that makes the difference. And the next question is, how do we leverage that into other areas? What are the best practices that we're seeing and that you're seeing as a supplier that you can bring back to us? So, you know, some of these are the low-hanging fruit that we all can adjust to, but it's how do we elevate that low-hanging fruit and bring it back into the organization and rethread it, right? So maybe it's not just how do we get standardized contracts, but it's, hey, in the future, these are the top three things that we're seeing other people do within that, I don't know, real estate leasing area or what have you, whatever they're looking at. So it's really being creative and asking the questions and making sure you have a provider that's going to be providing not just the set of job that you're looking for, that's the bare minimum, but it's creating that innovation within the legal community to bring back, to ask questions to how you're going to use that within your business model. That's where we see there's some really effective groups out there doing that around the country.